Lesson 17. Tell me about your furniture. Vocabulary for furniture. Prepositions.
Hello, students. How are you today? Today, we're going to talk about furniture for the home. But before that, we're going to talk about prepositions. Prepositions are very small words, but they're very important. So, now, in English, we have a preposition plus a noun or a pronoun. Okay? So always in English, preposition, noun, or preposition, pronoun. Okay? Now, we're going to look at prepositions of place. Prepositions of place. This answers the question where. Where, okay? So here we go. These are the small words that are very important. Okay, the first one is on. On, okay? The book is on the table. The book is on the table. Okay, now opposite is under. Under. The book is under the table. The book is under the table. In front of. Okay, now this is one preposition, but it's three words. In front of. In front of. The book is in front of the table. The book is in front of the table. Next we have above. Above, okay? The picture is above the table. The picture is above the table. Behind. Behind. The chair is behind the table. The chair is behind the table. Okay, now let me make some more room here and we'll do some more. Now remember, the preposition goes before the noun. Okay, here we go. Here's another one. Beside. Beside. The chair is beside the table. The chair is beside the table. Now this one is two words, next to. These are the same. Beside, next to. Okay, they're the same. The chair is next to the table. The chair is next to the table. Now we have in. In. All right. The pen is in the glass. The pen is in the glass. Between. Okay, this is for two things. For two things only. Okay? So, the lamp is between the chair and the table. The lamp is between the chair and the table. Between two things. Okay, that's good for now. Now, let's practice a bit. Now, assistants, I would like you to hold your pen in your right hand. Okay. Now, Put it in front of you. Okay. Put it behind you. Okay, it's kind of difficult, but you can do it. Okay, put it under your book. Under your book, good. Put it on your book. Put it on your book. Okay, now you can do this at home too. Isabel and Susan, put it between you and Ali. Okay, that works. All right, now put it over your head. All right, put it on your head. Oh, that's beautiful. Put it next to you. Next to you. Mm-hmm. Put it in front of you. Put it beside you. Okay. All right. Good. All right. You have prepositions. Okay. Now it's time to look and listen.
Look and listen.
The pen is on the book. The pen is in the book. The pen is under the book. The pen is between the book and the lamp. The pen is above my head.
Read and repeat.
All right, now let's look at vocabulary for furniture for the house. Okay, so furniture. All right, okay. Now, furniture is the word for the group. Okay, no S, never, no S. Okay, now each piece has its own name, and we'll start with the bedroom. Okay, now there is a bed in the bedroom. There is a bed in the bedroom. There is a table beside the bed. And on the table, there is a lamp. There is a table beside the bed, and on the table, there is a lamp. Okay, there is a carpet. There is a carpet. There is a dresser. There is a chest of drawers. Okay, there is a dresser, there is a chest of drawers. These are the same. These are the same. Okay? There is a mirror on the dresser. There is a mirror on the dresser, or there is a mirror on the chest of drawers. Okay? All right. Now let's make some room here, and we'll give you some more vocabulary for furniture. All right, here we go. There is a desk. There is a desk. Next to the desk, there is a lamp. Next to the desk, there is a lamp. There isn't any computer on the desk. There isn't any computer on the desk. Okay, now let's look at the kitchen and see what words we need for the kitchen. Okay, there is a stove in the kitchen. There is a stove in the kitchen. Now in England, this is a cooker, but in North America, it's a stove. There is a refrigerator, a big word for you, or short, fridge, in the kitchen. There is a refrigerator or fridge in the kitchen. There is a table and there are some chairs. There is a table and there are some chairs. There isn't any bed in the kitchen. There isn't any bed. Okay? All right. Now, let's look at the living room and see the words for the living room. First, there is a sofa. There is a sofa. There is a carpet in front of the sofa. There is a carpet in front of the sofa. There is a mirror above the sofa. There is a mirror above the sofa. There is a cabinet beside the sofa. There is a cabinet beside the sofa. Also, there is a green armchair. There is a green armchair. Okay? Now, that's the living room. Now let's look at the bathroom. Very important room. Okay, here we go. There is a toilet next to the sink. There is a toilet next to the sink. There is a mirror above the sink. There is a mirror above the sink. There is a light next to the mirror. There is a light next to the mirror. There is a plant on the toilet. There is a plant on the toilet. Very nice. And then finally, there is a bathtub. There is a bathtub. And there is a man in the bathtub. There is a man in the bathtub. Okay? Now, let's see what's in your house. Ollie, is there a sofa in your living room?
Yes, there is.
What color is it?
It is green.
Is there an armchair?
Yes, there are two armchairs. They are green too.
All right. Susan, is there a bed in your room?
Yes, there is.
Is there a desk in your room?
Yes, there is.
And what is on the desk?
There is a lamp and a computer.
All right. Isabel, is there a stove in your kitchen?
Yes, there is.
Is there a table?
Yes, there is.
Is there a computer?
No, there isn't.
All right, thank you very much. All right, now, we're going to look at a picture and describe the picture. So let me take this away, and I can write the sentences on the board, and you can also see them on the screen. All right, here we go. Now, here's a beautiful picture. The man is sitting on the chair. The man is sitting on the chair. Okay? He is sitting in front of the television. He is sitting in front of the television. The glass is in his hand, and it is on the table. The glass is in his hand and it is on the table. The slippers are on his feet. The slippers are on his feet. The table is next to the chair. The table is next to the chair. The wall is behind the chair. The wall is behind the chair. The chair is in front of the wall. Okay, these are opposite. The chair is in front of the wall. And the table is between the window and the chair. The table is between the window and the chair. Okay, now we're going to look at another picture, and I'm going to ask some questions about it. So here are the questions coming up, and then we can see. So you answer the questions at home. So where is the, it is, the, okay? Where is the, it is, the, So here is the preposition, and here is the noun, okay? Now, here we go, and we'll start with Ali. Ali, where is the lamp?
The lamp is beside the chair.
Yes, the lamp is beside the chair. Isabel, where is the ottoman?
The ottoman is in front of the chair.
Yes, the ottoman is in front of the chair. Susan, where is the carpet?
The carpet is under the chair and the ottoman.
Okay, the carpet is under the chair and the ottoman. Ali, ask Susan a question about this picture.
Susan, where is the book?
The book is on the ottoman.
Yes, the book is on the ottoman. Isabel, ask Ali.
Ali, where are the pictures?
The pictures are on the wall.
The pictures are on the wall. Susan, ask Isabel.
Isabel, where is the chair?
The chair is in front of the wall.
Yes, the chair is in front of the wall. Very good, thank you. All right, now it's time to look and listen.
Look and listen.
The lamp is on the table. The table is beside the chair. The television is in front of the chair. The carpet is in front of the chair. The wall is behind the chair. The television is between the window and the chair.
Read and repeat. Vocabulary for furniture. Present continuous tense.
Now, let's talk about what we do with the furniture. So here's the question. What do we do with the furniture? What do we do with the furniture? But first, let's look at some vocabulary. Some new, some old. Okay, first, sleep, sleep, sit, sit, put, put, cook, cook, eat, eat, watch, watch, wash, wash, read, read, play, play, and write, write. Okay? Sleep, sit, put, cook, eat, watch, wash, read, play, write. Okay, now let's also talk about present continuous. You saw this before. Remember that present continuous is something we're doing now, okay? And we use words like now, right now, at the moment, etc. Now, here is a picture of some people in a living room. And here's the question. What are they doing? What are they doing? Now, our assistants will answer the questions about this picture. We'll start with Susan. Susan, what is the woman doing?
She is reading newspaper.
She's reading the newspaper. And where is she lying?
She's lying on the sofa.
Yes, she's lying on the sofa. Ali, what is the child doing?
He's playing a game with his father.
Yes, he's playing a game with his father. And where are they?
They are sitting on the floor.
Yes, they're sitting on the floor. Actually, he's standing. But Isabel, what is the man doing?
He is playing with his son.
Yes, he is playing with his son. And where is he sitting?
He is sitting on the floor.
Okay, good. Now, we're going to look at another picture and I will ask you more questions. So, Ali, where are they?
They are in the kitchen.
And what is the woman doing?
She is cooking.
Yes, see, she is cooking. Isabel, what is the boy doing?
He is putting food into the refrigerator.
Yes, he is putting food into the refrigerator. Susan, what is the girl doing?
She is helping her mom.
Yeah, she's helping her mother. Ali, how many chairs are there?
There are three chairs.
Yes, there are three chairs. Okay, now here comes another picture. And more questions. So, Isabel, where are they?
They're at home.
Okay, where is the man?
The man is in the bedroom and the woman is going to the kitchen.
Yes, okay. The man is in the bedroom and the woman is going to the kitchen. What is she wearing?
She is wearing a dressing gown.
Yes, she's wearing a dressing gown. Ali, what is the man doing?
He is sleeping.
Yes, he is sleeping. And where is he?
He is in the bed.
He is in bed. And what is beside the bed?
A table and a clock.
Yes, a table and a clock are beside the bed. Where is the clock?
On the table.
Okay, the clock is on the table. Thank you very much. Now, let's look at some more practice, and we'll practice in a different way. Now, remember, when we use simple present verbs, it's a habit or a fact. We always do it. We use words like always, never, sometimes, etc. Now, here is a new question. And then we'll ask the assistants to help us. Okay, now remember, what are they doing is now, but here is a new question. What do we do with a... Okay, this is simple present. What do we do with a... Okay, so let's start with Ali. Ali, what do we do with a bed?
We sleep in a bed.
Do we sleep on a sofa?
Sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes. Susan, what do we do with a chair?
We sit on it.
Do we stand on it?
Sometimes.
Sometimes, yes. Isabel, what do we do with a table?
We eat on it. Sometimes we work on it.
Yes. Do you study on your table?
Sometimes.
Do you have a desk?
Yes, I do.
Do you study at your desk?
Yes, usually I study at my desk.
Okay. Now, Susan, what do we do with a television?
We watch a television.
Isabel, what do we do with an armchair?
We sit on it. We watch television there.
Yes. Good. Ali, what do we do with a stove?
We cook on it.
Do you cook, Ali?
Really.
Susan, what do we do with a bathtub?
We take a shower or we take a bath.
Yes, very good.
Pronunciation.
Now, let's do some pronunciation. Today we're going to do long O. O. All right? Now, here are some words with long O. And you can look at the spelling. O. O, O, home, home, so, so, cargo, cargo, coat, coat, note, note, phone, phone, bowl, bowl, and so. So, okay? These sound the same. Now again, O, home, so, cargo, coat, note, phone, bowl, so. Now look at the spelling here. We've got O, O, O. We have O, E, O, E, O. Remember, this is silent, makes this long. O, A, O, coat. O, W, here. Now this has different sounds, but here it's O, bowl. And sometimes this one, O, so, so. Okay? So this is O, 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 O. Different kinds of spelling. Makes English very interesting. Okay, now, let's compare some sounds. And we're going to do O. And remember, you don't have to know the words. This is only practice with the sounds. Okay, now, we've got O and ah. Okay? Now, first, bowl, bowl. Pole, pole. Coal, coal. Coast, coast. Coat, coat. Boat, boat. Woke, woke. Choke, choke. Sew, sew. And close, close. Okay, now this sound is kind of an ah sound, so it's kind of a mixed sound. Let me go over these again. First though, bowl, pole, coal, coast, coat, boat, woke, choke, sew, close. Okay, now let's look at these. Ball, this is the ah sound, okay? Ball, Paul, Paul, call, call, cost, cost, caught, caught, bought, bought, walk, walk, chalk, chalk. Now notice that there's no l, okay? This letter has no sound, ah. Saw, saw, and claws, claws. Okay, again, ball, Paul, call, cost, caught, bought, walk, chalk, saw, claws. Okay, all ah kind of sounds. Now, let's go across. Now at home, you listen and say at home, okay? Here we go. Bowl, ball. Pole, Paul. Coal, call. Coast, cost. Coat, caught. Boat, bought. Woke, walk. Choke, chalk. Sew, saw. Close, claws. Okay? So this is for the sound. Now, let's do three different sounds. Here we go. Now, we're going to do long O, soft A, and short U. So, long O, soft A, and short U. Okay? O, A, U. First, note, note. Comb, comb. Now again, this is silent. It's silent. Comb. No b. Comb. Cope, cope. Coat, coat. Robe, robe. Phoned, phoned. Okay? Note, comb, cope, coat, robe, phoned. Okay, soft A. Not, not. Calm, calm. Now again, no sound. Calm. cop, cop, cot, cot, rob, rob, fond, fond. Again, not, com, cop, cot, rob, fond. Now, let's do short U, sound. Nut, nut. Come, come. Cup, cup. Cut, cut. Rub, rub. And fund, fund. Okay? Nut, come, cup, cut, rub, fund. Okay, now we're going to go this way. So at home, you listen and say at home. Okay, are you ready? Note, not, nut, comb, calm, come, cope, cop, cup, coat, cot, cut, robe, rob, rub, phoned, fond, fund. Okay? So, you can hear the difference in the vowel sounds. Okay, now I have some wonderful sentences today that we'll practice. So our assistants will help and you can say them at home. So here we go. The first sentence. Dawn notes that Ron is not a nut. A nut is a crazy person, okay? Don notes that Ron is not a nut. Okay, Ollie, you try.
Don notes that Ron is not a nut.
Okay, good. Next one. So, the cop can't cope with the robber. So, the cop can't cope with the robber. Okay, Susan, give it a try.
So, the cop can't cope with the robber.
Yes, good. Okay, here comes another one. Those coats have a good cut. Those coats have a good cut. Okay, Isabel.
Those coats have a good cut.
Yes, good. Okay, here comes another one. Paul called from the coast. Paul called from the coast. Okay, Susan.
Paul called from the coast.
Yes, good. The cost at the coast is very low. Here's another O sound, okay? The cost at the coast is very low. Okay, Isabel?
The cost at the coast is very low.
Yes, very good. Thank you all very much. And now it's time to listen and write.
Listen and write.
Listen and write these words. Number one, armchair, armchair. Number two, dresser, dresser. Number three, stove, stove. Number four, Refrigerator. Refrigerator. Number 5. Carpet. Carpet. Now, check your work. Number 1. Armchair. Number 2. Dresser. Number 3. Stove. Number 4. Refrigerator. Number 5. Carpet. Now, listen and write these sentences. Number 1. There is a carpet between the sofa and the armchair. There is a carpet between the sofa and the armchair. Number 2. The lamp is on the desk beside the computer. The lamp is on the desk beside the computer. Number 3. The mother is sitting at the table in the kitchen. The mother is sitting at the table in the kitchen. Number 4. We sleep in a bed and sometimes on the sofa. We sleep in a bed and sometimes on the sofa. Number 5. The chair is in front of the desk and beside the wall. The chair is in front of the desk and beside the wall. Now, check your work. Number 1. There is a carpet between the sofa and the armchair. Number 2. The lamp is on the desk beside the computer. Number 3. The mother is sitting at the table in the kitchen. Number 4. We sleep in a bed and sometimes on the sofa. Number 5. The chair is in front of the desk and beside the wall. Now, read the story and answer the questions.
Read and answer.
Brenda is shopping for new furniture. Her house is big, so she is shopping for all the rooms. First, she is buying things for the kitchen. She is buying a new stove and refrigerator. They are white. She is also buying a table and 4 chairs. They are black. For the living room, she is buying a green sofa and 2 green armchairs. She has a carpet. It is green, red, and blue. It is between the sofa and 1 armchair. There is a small table beside 1 armchair. There is a lamp on it. Brenda also has a television. It is on a cabinet near the sofa. For the bedroom, Brenda is buying a nice big bed, 2 small tables, and a dresser. They are brown. Now, Brenda has a beautiful house, but no money. Now, listen to the questions and write the answers. Number one. What is Brenda buying for the kitchen? What is Brenda buying for the kitchen? Number two. How many chairs is she buying? How many chairs is she buying? Number three. What color are they? What color are they? Number four. What is she buying for the living room? What is she buying for the living room? Number five. What color is the carpet? What color is the carpet? Number six. Where is it? Where is it? Number seven. Where is the lamp? Where is the lamp? Number eight. What is she buying for the bedroom? What is she buying for the bedroom? Number nine. What color are they? What color are they? Number ten. Now, what does Brenda have? Now, what does Brenda have? Okay, now check your work. Number one. What is Brenda buying for the kitchen? She's buying a stove, a refrigerator, a table, and four chairs. Number two. How many chairs is she buying? She's buying four chairs. Number three. What color are they? They are black. Number four. What is she buying for the living room? She is buying a sofa and two armchairs. Number five. What color is the carpet? The carpet is green, red, and blue. Number six. Where is it? It is between the sofa and one armchair. Number seven. Where is the lamp? The lamp is on the small table beside the armchair. Number eight. What is she buying for the bedroom? She's buying a nice big bed, two small tables, and a dresser. Number nine. What color are they? They are brown. Number ten. Now what does Brenda have? She has a beautiful house, but no money. Very good. Thank you, and we'll see you next time.
Practicing English.
Guys.
Hi.
Please come in.
Do you know that painting project that you wanted to start in your living room?
Yeah.
Well, we are your painting crew.
Wow, that's great.
Yeah, Angie called me last night while I was watching television. I said I'd be glad to paint.
Yeah, me too.
Let's stop talking and get busy. Monica, where should we move these things? In your living room?
Well, the sofa can go over there next to the counter. The dining room table can go just in front of the wall. Over there.
What about this plant on the table?
That can go behind the sofa.
What about the dining room table and chairs?
Jack and Sam, could you please move it over in front of the wall? Alexi, could you roll the carpet up and put it in the kitchen? Thanks, guys.
What about this picture on the wall?
That can go on the floor, just in the kitchen for now. Okay, everyone, the living room and dining room are clear. The paintbrushes and paint are over there. Let's get painting.
Yeah. Hello?
Hello, Monica.
Yes?
Monica,
it's Michael from your psychology class.
Oh, yes, I remember you. How are you?
I'm great.
I'm also in your neighbourhood right now. You said it was
okay to call if I was in your neighbourhood. What are you
doing right now?
Right now? My friends and I are painting my living room.
Really? On such a nice Saturday?
Yeah, my friend surprised me. They came over about an hour ago. We're painting now.
I'm sitting at a cafe. Would you like to join me for coffee?
That's really kind of you, Michael, to invite me. But I can't leave my friends right now. We are painting.
Since I'm sitting here, with the rest of the day free, I could come and paint too. Do you have an extra brush for me?
Are you offering to join our party?
Yes, I am. I'm happy to come and paint with you.
And meet your friends.
Michael, that is very sweet of you to join us. I'll come down now to the cafe and get you.
That's great. I'm waiting for you.
Okay, bye.
Wow, Monica, you have some great furniture. Where did you get this dining room table and chairs?
Yeah, there's a great store. It's just 3 streets from here. I brought it 3 weeks ago.
Your sofa is great too.
Thanks. I bought it from the same store.
Hey, you two. Alexi, Angie, Jack and I are painting. You two are talking.
Sorry, Sam. We were just talking about the great furniture stores near here.
I'm just kidding. Hey, is anyone getting hungry?
Yeah, I am.
Me too.
Yeah, painting makes me hungry. Okay, I'm getting the idea that this crew needs to eat.
Well, I'll order pizzas for everyone.
There's a great place on the street behind us. I will order and go pick it up in about 30 minutes.
Great! Pizzas for lunch!
Excellent.
Don't get too excited. You'll have to wait till Michael arrives with the pizza.
No problem. I'll paint for pizza.